Hello, good evening. I'm Otway. This is Richard.
Hello. Hello, you.
Oh, I just mentioned, actually, you're very lucky. Tunbridge Wells has been chosen as the venue that we are going to film this tour on.
Smile.
So we thought, we looked at all the dates and we thought, Tunbridge Wells, there's a good place, didn't we? Honest. Right, as I said, I'm Otway, this is Richard. If you can't tell the difference between us, I'm the one with two hits. Right?
And I'm the one who can play them. Right?
And Richard just has the one that I sort of gave him, you know, a couple of years ago. But funnily enough, it turns out that the headline act, the Hamsters,
yes, you didn't know,
haven't got any hits at all.
Shocking.
Can you believe that?
How did that happen, John?
I don't know. And I actually felt a bit sorry for them because, like, for the last 28 years, I've always been able to go on stage and start with a hit, right? And the Hamsters have never been able to do that, right? Until now. Because what we've done, and I think it's really kind of us, is we've offered to share our big top 10 hit with the Hamsters.
Why not? Give it up.
And I don't know if you've seen the Hamsters before, but the difference now, astonishing, isn't it?
Not just a spring in their step, there's a strut.
Yes.
Isn't there? In their walk.
And the most...
strutting Hamsters.
The most exciting thing is that the start of their show is as good as the start of our show.
I know that doesn't bode well, right? But it does pick up.
So, what we do is we start off with my hit, right? And my hit dates back to 1977. Okay. Now, a lot of you will remember that that was the big year of punk rock. But come Christmas 1977, Mole of Kintyre was number one. Grandma, We Love You was number eight, but Caught Baby, That's Really Free was number 27! My first hit hasn't finished yet. I tell you something, if you spend 25 years with one hit, you don't miss bits out. You discover ways to make it last.
This is one of them. Actually, you just stop, don't you? For no apparent reason. Occasionally, I pretend to tune up.
So...
I'm not doing that now, though. All right, wait.
So, I wake up in the morning... Tell me, baby, what do you see? No, I see my true love. No, because it's my bloody hit, right? And she walks up and she kisses me. I say, "Cool, baby, that's really free." I don't want to come down to your house. Tell me, baby, is it good for me? Come on, pal. They just want to kick the arse out. "Cool, baby, that's really free. Really free, really free. Really, really, really free, kick me." Okay, what we're going to do now is the B-side of my first hit. One thing some of you will know, because I try and mention it a lot, the B-side sold just as many copies as the A-side. So we try and give it the same sort of respect that we give the hit itself. One of the ways we do this now, what used to happen in the past, me and Richard used to start this song together, right? But we hit a problem. And that was, people didn't recognize it.
I was one of them. Obviously, that was difficult.
And eventually, Richard worked out what it was. There are two chords at the beginning of this song, aren't there?
There are. Just the two.
Yeah. I was playing the right chords, wasn't I?
They're in the wrong order completely, which... As I say, if there's only two chords, it's critical, really, to get that bit right. So, not being picky or anything, is it?
No. And then Richard came up with this absolutely brilliant idea to get around it. Yes. That was simple. More diplomatic than that, wasn't it? Richard just suggested, why don't I start it on my own? Right? And so I let him.
Give it a chance.
And... you know that sound you get from an audience when they hear a song they really love? That happened, right? And because I'm a pop star, right? I like that sound. I mean, so much so that, I mean, I don't even mind you doing it on your own.
Yes,
okay, let's make this the big one, Frontway! Away. I'm on fire because I'm in love with a girl who's not a girl to us. When I was out with her, I saw you in the garden, baby. You look so dead on her. Beware of the flowers because I'm sure they're going to get you. Yeah. I'm on fire to say goodbye. Maybe I'll just kick myself inside. I really wanted to go home. You might say that today was the very last time I walked this way. Go tell him on your own. Well, I'd tell him where to go to, baby, but you know I wouldn't dare. Beware of the flowers, because I'm sure they're going to get you. Yeah. Thank you. disagree, disapprove. Maybe they all said that it was me that went out in the moon. How can you be so sure? Maybe when the love shines, it's pure. It's a light that shines in us. Well, I know someone who loves you, baby, and I know he really cares. Beware of the flowers, because I'm sure they're gonna get you.
It's only little. Very powerful, very talented.
Yeah! Right. Imagine this. A few years ago, I would have got to this point in my show and I would have ran out of hits.
Audience as well, usually.
And because I'm a professional, I instinctively knew that it was quite important to keep the people's attention, right? And I discovered that this worked surprisingly well. Richard never liked this guitar. And I couldn't work out why. Until, no, it was really funny.
You won't see it from my angle.
No. A little while ago, I caught him having a go, right? And it turns out that although Richard is probably a better guitarist this way round,
certainly louder
than me, funnily enough, he can't work this way round.
Not as well as that.
At all.
Like, see, it's just a niche market, John.
You see, he doesn't like it, does he? You can tell, can't you? And because I'm sort of talented in this way.
Special.
Yes. I get to start this song on my own, right? And I've sussed out, I worked it out the other day to get around the recognition problem. And I did it the other day and it worked. It's tell people what the song is before you start. Okay?
It doesn't always help.
It's an old sweet song called Blockbuster. Okay. Beware. I know. No, you better take care. Look, you better watch out if you've got long black hair. Hang on. Now, that look in his eyes. Okay, now don't be surprised if you can't see what's going on behind his disguise. Then nobody knows where Buster goes. Now he'll steal your woman out from under your nose. Hang on. Does anyone know the way? Hang on, did I hear someone say, we just haven't got a clue what to do? Oh. The cops are out. They're running about. They don't know if they can Blockbuster out. Well, he's got to be caught. Now he's got to be taught. Look, he's far more evil than anyone here ever thought. Now, does anyone know the way? Yes, there's got to be a way to Blockbuster.
Just
haven't got a clue what to do.
Doesn't normally go that well.
I know what we're going to do next. And this has been really, really going down well on this tour. You're going to like this. It's a little trick that I nicked from Madonna.
Not that one. The one you're thinking of.
And she was the first person I saw do this. Little device went around there and allowed her to run round the stage with both hands free.
It was useful for the trick you were thinking of.
But because I watched Blue Peter when I was a child, it was obvious to me that you could do exactly the same thing that Madonna did with a coat hanger. Look at this. First time Richard saw this, he said, "That's remarkable." So he makes me look like a front person.
Obviously got a hearing problem.
Look at this. It's amazing, isn't it? Complete and total freedom of the stage. I'll tell you what an impact this had, right? I did this on the first day of the tour. Second day of the tour, walked into Wilco's dressing room, yeah, opened the wardrobe, he had a row of these.
True. Hamster's dressing room?
Same thing.
Exactly, yeah. The same thing. Brought them out.
Right. So here we go, this is called "You Want to See Louisa Riding and a Riding on an Horse." 1, 2, 3, 4.
He's a-sailing me a saddle, go out on my street. This you and me together, I'll go for a ride. And up the bay on the hillside, and up on the wide cross. That you want to see Louisa riding and a riding, riding and a riding.
Together. Okay, what me and Richard do on this tour is we do little bits throughout the evening. We do a bit now and a bit in after the interval and a bit at the end. And the reason for that is it was spotted about right at the beginning of the tour that we actually work better in small doses.
It's easier to clear up, apparently.
So we're going to finish off our sort of first small dose. Well, it's a bit like a first impression, really, isn't it? And you want to leave a good first impression. So I had a chat to Richard about how we might do that. And he thought just leaving it to my vocals probably wasn't the best idea. And he said, how about this? And I hadn't realised it before, but Richard's actually a very, very good heavy metal guitarist. I'd always thought the heavy metal stuff was a bit naff. But Richard, like, was doing all this stuff in the dressing room, and I actually thought, well, that is quite clever. I mean, I can't do it.
Sometimes with a guitar.
And so we'll give this a go. This is one of Richard's favourite heavy metal songs. It's an old Bachman Turner Overdrive song. It's called You Ain't Said Nothing Yet.
Because the top of the head isn't flat, but the first one was a dog. Second one, obvious, a rabbit. So I want to make that clear. Shut up, ladies and gentlemen.
I knew I had it coming to me, but I wanted it that way. She said, any love is good loving. So I took what I could get, I took what I could get, and then she looked at me with her big brown eyes and said, you ain't seen nothing yet. Baby, you just ain't seen nothing yet. Okay, no. Here's something you're never gonna forget. Because you ain't seen nothing yet. You ain't been around. And now I'm feeling better. Now I've found out for sure. She took me to a doctor and he told me I was cured. He said any love is good loving. So I took what I could get, I took what I could get, and then she looked at me with her big brown eyes and said, you ain't seen nothing yet. Baby, you just ain't seen nothing yet. Okay, now, here's something you're never gonna forget. Okay. nothing yet. You ain't been around.
Oh, Thank you. Thank you.
I'm not afraid to die.
this evening. There will be a short intermission, after which things will become unfathomable. I'd like to leave with something I wrote back in those fabulous 70s. Yeah.
Hello again. We've just been discussing how we should start the second half. And we've decided we're going to start it off with a bit of punk rock. Okay, now this bit of punk rock comes from my new album.
And mine.
And it's his new album, yes. It's our new album. Basically, next year we're doing a world tour. Right, as you do. And because we're not very famous in certain parts of the world, we decided the only way we can really do it and be sure to get full houses is take the audience with us in our own jet, right? Now, this has actually turned out to be quite expensive, right? So one of the ways we're going to fund it is we've recorded a new album.
Altair.
Yes. And as long as we sell enough of those albums, we'll be okay. So they're available if you want to help us on our way.
Is that the ad break over?
Yeah, that's it. So this bit of punk rock came about. I have a daughter. And when she was 3 and 4 years old, I remember going around HMV and Virgin Records looking for punk rock for tots, right? And there wasn't any. And when I got emailed some lyrics about the fairy story Rumpelstiltskin, I remember thinking, there must be lots of parents like me, right? And I thought, punk Rumpelstiltskin, I mean,
as that, only you could.
Yes, that'll do, isn't it? So there we go. They come over from Unpert, acting like an introvert. You treat me like a jerk, you make me do all the work. You're just a bog flirt, a pretty girl in your skirt. Rub my face in that girl, what don't you?
Just
give us the baby, give us the baby. Michael Jackson, Michael Jackson.
Continent donkey. You like it? It's quite expensive, that was, actually. You see exactly where he's been. He's very happy now, look, because he's found out he can smoke it. Anyway.
Here's something really strange. I mean, it's strange for us on this tour is that people have been turning up on this tour that are really into fine music. And the reason for that is both Wilco and the Hamsters do, in fact, provide fine music. But those people don't normally come to see us. And because of that, most of those people have never seen these before. There's really no reason why they should. So. Left Buttock Tom Tom.
That's why the last album was called The Set Remains the Same.
No, that's just... That was just the sound check. When I started working with Richard, he'd never worked with somebody that hit themselves before. And this song used to be really quite chaotic. But because, you know, he's a good musician, very quickly he got used to me hitting myself.
I quite enjoy it now.
And, you know, this song became quite tight, and by tight I mean boring. So what we've now got is my theremin. Okay.
We decided to go for the glittery ones, no expense spared on this one.
And the way that this is used in this song, because I've discovered that if I throw one of these in willy-nilly during the song, and the trick is even I've not got to know when I'm going to do it, I can sometimes throw Richard. Right?
Careful, you might go off.
See? And because he has pride, it is actually quite...
I'm here.
It is actually quite fun watching him get thrown. See? So you go, this is Body Talk with... Theremin! From your head to your toes is Body Talk. Biting your nails never fails to be a giveaway. Well, it's good, well, it's bad. Oh, honey, it's all said by Body Talk.
Body Talk.
And Eddie, here's nobody talking.
Body Talk.
And Eddie, here's nobody walking.
Body Talk.
And Eddie, here's nobody scratching. And Eddie, here's nobody talking to you. Every time you breathe, every time you sneeze, Body Talk. If you're having a good time, or just plain bored or undecided, if you're thinking of me passionately, I can see my Body Talk. Can you hear? My Body Talking, can you hear? My Body Shouting. Richard, I'm making so much noise with my body. The way that you run, the way that you walk is on Body Talk. Is that my expensive guitar. I got this because when we had the big top 10 hit record and...
Sorry, what was that, John?
When we had the big top 10 hit record and we were on the way to do Top of the Pops.
Sorry?
And on our way to do Top of the Pops. I remember thinking, now I'm a big chart act. Obviously, a lot more people are going to come and see me. And I noticed over the years that quite a lot of people told me that my guitar didn't sound very good. Right? So I thought, now's the time to fix that problem. And so I bought a really expensive guitar. But it was only after I spent the money that Richard told me something quite interesting about guitars. And that is that the workmanship and the quality of the guitar goes some way towards the sound, but more important is where you put your fingers. And he said, why didn't you just go and buy yourself a chord book?
Right? Because you couldn't afford one after that.
Well, Richard was actually quite nice because I spent the money on, you know, on the guitar, he went and actually bought me a chord book.
I did, yeah. Which he coloured in absolutely beautifully. He's very good in that area, but you did learn page one, didn't you?
Yeah. Well,
and luckily, all of the chords from page one are in this song, aren't they?
Well, you know what it's like? If you get a new toy, first few days you've got it, you know, you play with it a lot, and I did that with your guitar and the chord book. And bloody hell, it's really made, you know, big difference. I'll tell you how much. The other day, me and Richard were walking off stage, and he said, that sounded quite good tonight. Yes. I mean, this
I
is...
I don't remember that, but...
this is
a... to spoil a good story, doesn't it? Especially when he's in full flow.
But this is a nice song called Josephine. And, if you remember what it used to sound like, I mean, listen to it now, okay?
With tired eyes
your heart is in safe keeping. And nature's girl today can wipe her tears away. Her time to shine has nearly come. In the church, they pray for harvest. You hear the church bells ring. And Jeffereins are in the bar tonight to see the May Day in. But you, the Queen, and life isn't quite as easy. God bless the libertine that lies within our Josephine. And the crowd scream, Josephine, our May Day eyes are on you. When we put this tour together and me and Richard offered to share our hit with the Hamsters,
pretty big of us, I think.
Yeah. One thing they were unaware of at the time was the fact that the big hit is in fact a disco song. Right. Now, it turns out that the rhythm section of the Hamsters, in a previous incarnation of the band, had played a lot of disco, so they were quite au fait with that particular genre.
That's quite good, isn't it?
However, Slim over here had never done disco before in his life.
Despite appearances.
My dignity was hitherto intact before I started working with her.
So, when we did all the rehearsals for this tour,
that's rubbish, by the way, they weren't any.
One thing we made Slim do, just to get him into the mood for disco, was a practice the dance. Right? And it's worth watching him practice the dance because it's bloody funny. Go on, practice.
You're really horrible. I'll only do it if Richard will do it with me.
Go on. Can you?
That's hard work for him. I'm a natural.
Are you ready for this? For the first time ever, the Hamsters doing disco and the Hamsters doing a hit.
Hang on, look, we've taken a lot of unfair stick from him every night. He gives us real stick.
Not unfair.
About Top of the Pops. But this is, we think there's a very important fact about all this Top of the Pops business that he's leaving out is the fact that The week after he went on Top of the Pops, his single went down the charts. I bought 3 bloody copies of that thing, but it went down. And we did some research, and we found in the long and illustrious history of the British pop charts, 50 years or more, that's only ever happened to one other artist. And that was Lena Zavaroni.
Who I think was great. Besides which, you've got to be there in order to go down, haven't you?
Listen, you. We would never dream of pandering at the lowest common denominator like you corporate sellouts. We're a cult. I mean, what kind of eco-warrior are you, Swampy? Honestly.
Okay, let's be friends
it,
now.
It does rankle.
Let's play nicely.
Are you ready for a hit? Yes. Okay, here we go. There's a rare isotope of hydrogen that gets us into heavy water! I'm an alchemist, baby! I can turn heavy metal into gold. I can make an unstable compound. Or mercury explode. I can make you glow. I can make you phosphorus. I can blast your bubble. I can make you FMS. It sounds so the slurs, a chemical reaction in the brain. Let me be your Bunsen burner, let me be your naked flame.
Burn, baby, burn.
Let me be your Bunsen burner.
Burn, baby, burn.
Let me be your naked flame.
Burn, baby, burn.
Litmus test on you. Acid it was. Acid it is. What acid is true? Check out what's in the test tube, baby. You're my little pipette. You're my favourite piece of apparatus in my chemistry set. Sounds, doesn't slur. It's a chemical reaction in the brain. Let me be your Bunsen burner. Let me be your naked flame.
Burn, baby, burn.
Let me be your Bunsen burner.
Burn, baby, burn.
Let me be your naked flame.
Burn, baby, burn.
Let me be your Bunsen burner.
Burn, baby, burn.
Let me be your naked flame. In order to achieve a faster, more sustainable reaction, you obviously use a form of catalyst or possibly a source of heat. For instance, the Bunsen burner. You are the kind of carbon that I can date. You're the element that makes me passionate. There's a chemistry experiment I want to try in my brain. Get close to the Bunsen burner. Feel the heat of the naked flame. Sound does nerves, a chemical reaction in the brain. Let me be your Bunsen burner. Let me be your naked flame.
Burn, baby, burn.
Let me be your Bunsen burner.
Burn, baby, burn.
Let me be your naked flame.
Burn, baby, burn.
Let me be your Bunsen burner.
Burn, baby, burn.
Let me be your naked flame.
Burn, baby, burn.
I know what I'm doing. I am a chemist. Now this is quite interesting.
Burn, baby, burn.
Have you tried covalent bonding?
Burn, baby, burn.
Watch out for these two together. Number 9. And now the hamsters have got to try and follow it. Ladies and gentlemen, the hamsters!
The brat out of hell and his faithful tonto, Richard Holgarth, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, do not wait. The man about Hillsborough said, I can't believe it's not better. Anyway.
Later, folks. Hey, we're the Hampsters from over the water in South End on Sea. A delight to be here with our good friends Whitwell Johnson and John Otway here this evening in funky downtown Tunbridge Wells. All the mad, the bad, and the dangerous. All right, we'll play a little rock and roll for you. This one's all about cars and women. Saturday night downtown, I was cruising around.
Lucky in love. Well, baby, so lucky. Guitar down. My baby, she left me 'cause I wouldn't let my guitar down. Since she left me, I've been rocking from town to town. Left my home in Southend and I headed up to London town. Left my home in Southend and I headed up to London town. Stopped off in Brentwood and I really had to get on down. They like my guitar sound. Pretty women come to see me 'cause I say they like my guitar sound. Go downtown, yeah.
way from the Thames River Delta for you, and a savage indictment of our criminal justice system, ladies and gentlemen. Style R&B thing for you. and it's called Ooh Baby Ooh.
Ain't working out right. I got a world of suspicion. don't take my car, put my foot to the floor. I got a bad soon, I don't sit this by the wishing no more.
Place where we could make a little
get up, my views is lit.
Yeah.
to the thief. There's too much confusion. I can't get no relief. Then this man that drank my wine. Now man, dig my herb. And none of them.
Yes, I know you heard how the Texas hop. I know you heard. lips and close your eyes. Will they walk? Will they walk?
Hey, walk.
Will they walk? Do you walk?
Music right now. I trust us.
You know what I mean? representing kind of nonchalant.
Of ourselves right now.
Yeah, I know where I'm gonna do. Roberts, ladies and gentlemen.
City Rollers rubbish.
Yes. It turns out that both of us as musicians can play an Osman song. Right? They've got to guess which one it is. Is it a Puppy Love?
Long-haired lover from Liverpool?
Crazy Horses!
Hey, one, two, three, four! Yeah.
Everywhere. It's a warning, it's on every turn. Gotta stop those crazy horses on the run. Well, sure, there they go, smoking up the sky. Yeah. Crazy horses and their riders, and you and I.
Come on.
roses and they're right into you and I.
Just me.
Of the tour. It's born to be mad, bad, dangerous, and
I'm gonna make it happen.
finish with this, really. Some of you won't know this, but in the lineup of musicians we have here, there is a dark horse in the band. There is a dark horse. I didn't know for the first couple of weeks of this tour, and I only found out because I was in the dressing room talking to a pleasant-looking young lady about my chart career and about my top 10 hit.
For God's sake.
When from the corner of the dressing room came this voice saying, well, yes, but I've had a number one that's sold a million. Right. It didn't come from there, did it? Who is the dark horse? It turns out it's Little Norman. He's had a number one million seller, right? And I was so shocked, all I could say was, all right then, what million seller number one did that happen to be then?
Japan, from Milan to Yucatan.
Don't forget the hamsters.
I'm number one, right?
Number one!
Thanks so much, everybody. We very much appreciate you coming along. We hope you enjoyed the show. Thank you. And if you want us to let you know about the DVD, leave your names around the front there and we'll write you when it's out. Thank you so much.